take one home with you, and hopefully subscribe. Greg Notas, who is going to be speaking to us in this session about adventures in advanced search, is a faculty and graduate services librarian at Montana State University Library. Strangely enough, that's in Montana, in case you were wondering. And he has been a regular columnist for Online Magazine and Online Search Magazine for many, many years. He is a recognized expert in web searching, and he will share his knowledge about advanced search with us during this session. Greg.
The adventure title, along with the lower part of the screen, that's also Montana. And I decided I was going to try to get through 50 tips in 40 minutes, because usually with any of these, I can spend, you know, 10, 15, 20 minutes talking about just one of these, but probably almost all of these, some of you already know and use regularly. Hopefully all of you that none of you know and give you something new to look at and start with. So I've got the number to keep me on track as well. And of course, what I often have to remind myself is start simple. We get to learn all these tricks of the trade, different things we can do, but a lot of times, and especially with web search, Google optimizes for people that don't know all this. So I'm looking for US libraries per capita, just type it in. I can say United States, I can say US in multiple formats. I've got a U period S, not period, typed in, because that's just the way I typed it. And Google's fine with that. It gives a result pointing to an ALA website right at the top. But I also always encourage all of us to diversify our sources. We get used to our sources we go to. And if all we do is another Google search that our patron would have done anyway, and all we already did do, we're not necessarily adding much value. So look somewhere else. You're going to get different results. You get different ranking, even at something like Bing, where I can do the exact same search. And here I'm getting from something from statemaster.com. And also a result from Quora, which might be interesting to look at how other people have gone in. And this is looking at per capita, right at the title, whereas, what we saw here didn't have per capita in the title. You have to dig a little further to see how relevant. Also, take a look at the advanced search pages. Yes, they're harder to find at Google, and they're not always accurate, but they often give a great idea for whatever search tool you're using what some of the advanced capabilities are. So for example here, if you can find Google patents, which is sort of buried on Google's website now, and you can then find their advanced search, it shows you the different fields that are available. So that if you're going to do a search in there, it generally gives you an idea of what you might want to look for and what other ways you might narrow the results and make them more precise. Just like in a commercial database, in this case on EBSCOhost, this is CINAHL, where they've got, for nursing, they've got clinical queries, they've got a checkbox where the first author is a nurse. Make sure you just get randomized control trials. You can have geographic limits. So web searching is not often that well structured to get to most of that, but sometimes it is, like you see in the Google Patent Search over here. The warning, of course, with advanced search pages is because less than 10% of users ever get to them, or 1%, sometimes the engineers at the search company forget to update it. So there's some Google Advanced Search pages that have features that don't even actually work anymore. So always look at results with a critical eye and evaluate as to whether or not it's actually done what you hoped it did. Titles change. This is probably no great surprise to any librarian out there, but it's always something that I find good to remind myself. I had a student come in, they were looking to cite this thing they pulled off the web. I forget which major newspaper website it was from, and they were trying to find it in our databases to sort of get a more official version to cite in their paper. Of course, they could not find it anyway they were looking. And so I tried the same things real quickly, and then said, well, let's grab a sentence from the actual text, especially the first paragraph, put it in the double quotes in the phrase search, so it searched exactly in that order, and then I was able to find the same article with a completely different title, so that we could get the version that she had wanted to cite. But I found the same thing to be true with journal articles. You get published in advance of print, a preprint version from an institutional repository, and the title does not always stay the same. So just a reminder, I love doing title searches. That's usually my go-to if I've got a citation, and I'm going to search it on the web and in our databases. But just remember, it doesn't always remain static. And I like using title searches because the phrase often is unique, at least in academic kinds of literature. We used to advise not to use web date limits because they were so inaccurate. Okay, they're still inaccurate. But they've gotten better. And just remember, web's old now. I mean, it's been around over 20 years. In terms of technology, that's ancient. And you can go into Google search tools. On the upper right-hand side, you see that button you can press, and then you can actually choose custom range. So I just did a search here and limited it to 95 through the end of 98, January 1st, 99. You can use this nice little calendar. And not every page I get will have the accuracy from that date, but at least it's a great way to look at the past and get the majority or at least some of the pages which are actually from that time period. And of course, you don't just use date limits for the old stuff. You can also narrow to the past hour, the past 24 hours. If you're trying to look something up about any political figure or celebrity, oh, Donald Trump, Strangle of Worlds. And there's an awful lot written about Trump, especially these days, right? So if you're trying to get really the most recent, the past hour is a great kind of limit to use, as well as going into the news site. But that's just going to bring sort of the, however the algorithm determines top stories, you can put your own queries in and limit to the past hour, past 24 hours. Google Alerts. How many of you have Google Alerts set up? Did you notice about a year or so ago they just sort of stopped working? So if you had Google Alerts and you just sort of forgot about them and filtered them off somewhere else because they weren't working anymore, for the about the past year now they seem to be working better. I wouldn't trust them 100%, but they are working again. You can set up a Google Alert without an account and just send it to your email. But if you do log in first to Google, it does give you that option down on the bottom to not only get email, but get an RSS feed, so you can then throw it into a widget and actually put new results on your website, or put it into a feed reader if you're still using RSS reading. So who knows how long it'll last, but Google Alerts, and especially if you've got a nice, narrow search that there's not usually a lot being published on, but you can actually get Google Alerts for stock news. Throw in a ticker symbol, get it from Google Finance, and you'll get lots and lots of email if it's a frequently mentioned stock. Locate yourself. So let's say what happens for me a lot, I'm at Montana State University, our on-campus IP address is 153.90.whatever-else. And so a lot of times when I'm helping a patron, I need to know if they're on campus where access should work seamlessly, or if they're off campus and they're feed, so you can then throw it into a widget and actually put new results on your website, or put it into a feed reader if you're still using RSS reading. So who knows how long it'll last, but be smart and sometimes turn it off and actually want it still on. So there's several ways that you can do this. You can go to what's my IP. .org has been my go-to, and then I also just came across the whatismyipaddress.com, which I just had to show because, oh, that's very interesting. So up in the hotel room where I was on Hotel Wireless, it located me smack dab in middle Kansas. Now we're getting better where it's at least looking a little bit closer. But you can also just search IP in Google, or if you're talking on the phone with somebody or chatting with them, say, go to Google, search IP. Actually, you may not want to say that over the phone, come to think about it. You may not come across quite so well as IP. I haven't thought of that before. But if you're chatting, you can show them this kind of window and type IP in Google and just the two letters this way, and it shows the public address. And so you can help with troubleshooting, or you can check yourself if your VPN is working or how your proxy is working. A lot of times we talk about individual commands like the site colon or file type, but remember you can really do some fascinating things when you combine some of these. So for example, let's say file type and int title. So I'm looking for Microsoft Word documents that in the title have internal or confidential, or both in this case. Let's see what comes up right now. And you actually pull some things up, including something which I have not actually looked at, but is from the World Bank. Confidential for internal discussions only. So by using internal twice there, it wraps funny here, but notice I've got in title, internal, in title, confidential, colon, right after the in title. I'm saying I want each of those words to be in the title. If I left off the second in title prefix, confidential would just occur anywhere. In URL, specialized command to say somewhere in the URL string, I want this particular term to appear. And you can combine that with site. So for example, let's say a lot of blogs, I don't know, I just came across a couple of blogs recently where the blogger was wordy, very long blog, and I wanted to skim what other things this blogger had written. And I went to the monthly archive. And instead of just having the title of the posts anywhere, every archive page in the blog had a full, about four-page long blog post. That made it really hard to browse. So that's where I could take a look at, say, on this website, put in URL, in this case 2013, let's see everything, because that date is used actually in the URL for the structure, pretty common on WordPress sites. So for example, here on John Tedesco's site, I searched for the IRE conference, it's the acronym for Conference for Investigative Reporters, and was able to find three results from his blog that was mentioning that conference. I'm thinking about this. In the title of my site, I say in URL and site. You don't need the Boolean operator. I say in URL. No space.
Had a full, about four-page long blog post. That made it really hard to browse. So that's where I could take a look at, say, on this website, put in URL, in this case 2013, let's see everything, because that thing is used actually in the URL structure, pretty common on WordPress sites. So for example, here on John's Facebook site, I searched for the IRE conference, the Conference for Investigative Reporters, and was able to find three results from his blog that was mentioning that conference.
I meant to say, this presentation is not
written about this. In the title of my site, I say in URL and site, don't need the Boolean operator. I say in URL, no space, and it's about 4 pages long in blog posts. So that made it really hard to browse. So that's where I can take a look at saying on this website, put in URL, in this case 2013, let's see everything, because that thing is used correctly in the URL structure. We'll see pretty well on WordPress sites. So for example, here on John's Facebook site, I searched for the IRE conference, able to find three results from the blog that was mentioning that conference.
I meant to say, this presentation is not written about this.
In the title of my slide, I say in URL and site, but in the URL, no space, that's the right thing.